pretty one your eyes sees. There it is.
Hello, BookTube. I'm Sean the Book Maniac. Welcome back to my channel. Well, those of you who saw my January TBR, you probably agree with me that I have enough fabulous reading on my plate, but I'm about to add a little bit more because today I found out about a readathon happening in January, so I'm a little late to the party. I'm filming this on Wednesday, January 9th, but I'm gonna take part anyway. It's called Read Yo Shelves, and it is hosted by Kathy Trithard and her Instagram buddy who's not on BookTube, Steph. I'll put all this in the show notes, but Steph's Instagram is Read Books, Love Books. And the point of it is to read books that are already on your shelves. So I'm already doing some of that. I'm just scatterbrained because I'm so excited and I don't have much time before I have to go to work. But they have a bingo card, and I'm planning to do the top strip. And one of the books that I've just recently added to my January TBR will fit one of them. And I'm adding 4 more books to my January TBR because they're books I'm dying to read. They're books on my shelves, and I just want to be a part of this. So, and if I kind of just amp up my reading a bit and finish most of what I'm currently reading or currently committed to be buddy reading, giving myself an extra 4 or 5 days at the end of the month, and start a couple. Anyway, let's see how it works out. So here's the bingo card. And see that top row? I'm planning to fulfill all of those prompts. Gift, newest acquired, diverse, oldest book, which they said could be the oldest book on your shelf or the book you've owned the longest, and cover by. Okay, so let me show you. Gift. This is a book that was a gift from a Litzy friend. She's now my Instagram friend too. And she sent me this a couple years ago. This is a ARC, actually, from Archipelago Books. Angel of Oblivion by Maja Hatterlap. I talked about this book on a video during Women in Translation Month. I didn't get to it then, but Britta Bowler was very enthusiastic to see that I had it and told me she thought I would like it. I believe that's what she told me. And it was a gift, and I'm dying to read it. So I am going to try to fit it in for Read Your Shelves. Because it's an ARC, there is nothing that says what it's about, but I believe it's political, maybe East German. Let me pull something up here. Oh, now I remember. She is part of the Slovenian-speaking minority of southern Austria. And this is I'm not sure how autobiographical it is, but it's a story about the partisans from within that group who fought against the Nazis during World War II. It sounds absolutely fascinating. Newest acquired. Well, I acquired this because, and it's a crazy story, but Sharon of Hooked on Books, she's recently come back, and because I bailed on some other stuff this month, you'll hear quite a bit about that in the Friday Reads, which will be going up around the same time this video goes up. I had a little bit of space, so I contacted Sharon because months ago, we talked about reading a Chinese novel, 5 Spice Street by Can Zhu. She said, yeah, let's read it. And I said, oh, yeah, actually, and wait a minute. Let me read a few pages to make sure it's going to be okay. And I read a few pages, and I was underwhelmed. And then I checked reviews of that book. And the things that certain readers didn't like are things that I tend not to like. So I said, you know what? Maybe not. After I asked her, and she said yes, and I said, maybe not. But I said, I've had a look at your Goodreads TBR, and here's a short list of books that I would like to read. Whether I own them or not, I would love to read. And so the one that she, of that short list that Sharon said she would be interested in buddy reading with me, I bought the same day, and I now have it. And that is Such Small Hands by Andres Barba. I heard Eric Carl Anderson talk about it last year, and it's a short little book, and it's my most recently acquired, so I'm going to be doing it. And what the hell is this about? I can't remember. It's not about the shithole president of the United States. I remember that it was kind of weird. Shirley Jackson meets the Virgin Suicides. Spanish writer, and it's set in an orphanage. That's all I need to know. I don't know whether I'll like it. I'm going to read it and buddy read it with Sharon, and I'm not going to bail, and it's going to fit for my read your shelf prompt. Next, diverse, which is a word that I think is really silly, but lots of people use it. So I have chosen a novella I didn't get to during novellas in November, Houseboy by Ferdinand Oyono. And Oyono is a Cameroonian novelist, and this is his novel about a houseboy. And I'm going to read it this month, I hope. Oldest book, I went with one of the very few novels or works of fiction that I actually brought with me to Japan almost 10 years ago that I haven't read. And that is a Haruki Murakami novel, South of the Border, West of the Sun. I've never read it, don't know what it's about. Set in an affluent Tokyo suburb in 1951. Should be interesting. I've kind of soured on Murakami, but I still tend to enjoy his earlier stuff, and I will give his newest novel a try, but maybe not this year. But I'll finally get to this one. And cover by Crudo, Olivia Lang. I don't know if it's going to be a Sean book. If it's kind of like Ali Smith's Autumn, I will love it, but I'm worried, but total cover by and short. So those are the ones I'm going to try to fit in. I think the Hatterlap, I'm going to start now and read a few, you know, a little bit over the next couple weeks. And I'm doing this buddy read with Sharon over a couple days, in about a week or 10 days. I can't remember it. I have it written down. So these two, that one will be finished soon. That one I'll get in progress. And then if I finish all my other stuff and have 4 or 5 days at the end of January, I can knock these three off. So that's my plan. All right, so I'm totally stoked to try to get as many of those five to complete the top row. And then I'm already reading a bunch of stuff that'll fit some of the other squares. So I think you should jump in too. There's no time like the present. People, read your shelves. Thanks for watching.